years through space and time to be here to talk to one of you because my shoe is, my crew is in crisis. I'm sorry, my shoe is off as well. you see, I'm from the Starship Odyssey. My ship is a crew of very talented, beautiful human beings, but they are about to face a disaster, and I have to avert it. My name is Iliad. I'm the improvised life form of information assistance and drink dispensing. I am both the AI for the computer and for the ship, and I'm also its 24-hour bartender. And I believe, if we calculated this correctly, someone in this room is facing a crisis very similar to ours. 500 years in the future, we've solved a lot of problems, but not all of them. And I'm sure you're facing some of those today yourself. So if someone could please raise your hand once you have inspiration. Don't say anything, but if you are facing a crisis, maybe your country is facing a crisis, or you personally are facing a crisis, if there's an issue you care about, keep them up. Does anyone have an issue in their life? Yes, good, good, good. May I speak with you for a moment? What is your name?
My name is Beth.
Hi, Beth, I'm Iliad.
Hi, Iliad.
What is this issue that you are facing?
The pipes in my building are very, very old.
The pipes in your building are very, very old. I take by inference you were referring to the place you live when you say my building.
Yes.
I see. Is this a place that you own or is this a place that you rent?
It's a condo, so I own part of it.
Ah! Yes, sorry, I should have brushed up on 2019. And so these pipes being very old, how does that affect your life negatively?
The pipes have scaling on the inside of them, so it shows up in the air conditioning and the heating units.
I see. So there's an issue with your home that is degrading it. Does anyone here have a similar issue, or do you feel, is there anything about your home that's getting degraded as well? Yes.
My roommates and I have trouble bringing on AC temperature.
An AC temperature. Ah, you're referring to air conditioning.
Yes.
Yes, so you live with multiple people and you can't decide what temperature to keep it at.
Yes.
I see, yes. The perils of living in an age where we haven't solved temperatures and water supply is very frustrating. Beth, if you could give me one piece of advice for future generations who might be facing the same degradation of their home, what piece of advice would you give them?
Look at the blueprints.
Welcome, please, yes. Look at the blueprints. Thank you so much. That actually, I think that'll do it. That'll be what we need. Thank you so much. Now, I must return to my own time frame. I can't, tell you everything that happened, but I will leave you with a holographic representation of the events leading up to me coming here. And with any hope, we can still save the future.
PR trip. We're just gonna represent the fleet, talk to people, explain why infrastructure is important. It's really an easy job, and we're gonna meet a lot of people from the galaxy. And normally I'd be so disappointed that this is how we're going to go out, but we've seen a lot of loss. We've endured a lot of stress. And so if we can just go on what's essentially a junket, meet some people, have some sort of R&R that's masquerading as work, then yeah, I'll take it. After 15 years, I think we deserve a break.
You know, Cap, I can't wait to get recommissioned. This ship is, quite frankly, it's a rust bucket.
Yep. Yeah, it's a rust bucket, but it's been home for 15 years and it's saved a lot of lives, so...
She still works pretty good, Captain. She may be a rust bucket, but it's a solid rust bucket.
Kazanus, your generation is so ungrateful. This rust bucket kept us alive. And when I retire, I'm going to write a book about it.
If I take as many hits as this old girl did, I'll be pretty happy.
Look, just because I grew up on this ship doesn't mean I don't know a thing or two about it.
All right.
Means you take it for granted because you don't know any better.
Boy, I can't wait till I'm captain one day.
You'll never be captain!
Sorry.
Take it easy, I'm blue.
You will never be captain. You are lazy.
Here. Can't wait till I pretend to get along at this conference.
Get along. Nerves are frayed.
Yeah, I just want to say, you know, I really have enjoyed all my time with all of you guys. You know, it's been 15 years of joy for me. Even you, Ember. And Blue. Oh, God.
Berman, I thought you were a goner on that last mission. But here you
are. Captain, I'm sorry. He has been mispronouncing my name because he hates my species!
He does it to get a rise out of you, and you're rising to it. It's not nice.
You guys should
fight. You're pretty nice to everybody but him, and I think we all know why.
He has his brain on the outside of his head! Oh. It's freaking weird!
Oh, it's weird.
Can I just say that? It's
hey,
weird!
Peter, maybe you shouldn't be in the front lines of this galactic summit if you're going to call people weird, Berman.
You know, I was telling everybody how I got along with them, and it turned into me making fun of you, and I didn't mean that. I love you even though you're weird.
Oh, Captain, the men on the ship are exhausting me. Permission to go lie down and take a nap.
Permission granted.
All right, here I go.
You guys gonna fight?
They're not gonna
fight while I'm napping. You know the rule.
I'm not going to fight because when we get to the Galactic Conference, I will see my men and I will be in a happy place once again. I will not entertain this anymore. It's
gonna be nice for you to see some old friends.
It will be very nice for me to see old friends.
Oh, you guys are gonna fight.
I'm not on the bridge.
Insulation! All infrastructure needs temperature control. I present you a titanium crystal installation that will solve all of your problems. Others live in your domicile. Oh, it's too hot. Oh, it's too cold. Oh, titanium! Titanium senses what each individual needs and insulates. So good.
And is this one going to blow up and destroy half of Xandar just like the last one?
That was fun.
That was a test phase. We're beyond it. And I swear, I would not bring shoddy products to a galactic infrastructure conference.
How much can we charge?
That's where you come in. You're my sales team. I just feel like I'm killing it on this presentation here. Any of you guys that actually go out there and pay?
The only thing you're killing is my brain cells.
I want to make sure that we can overcharge. I want to make sure that this titanium will ruin anyone that tries to install it. Will it drain their coffers so we can get rich?
Is it fixable by other people?
The answers to these questions would conflict with each other. It's a perfectly reasonable insulation. I've been mastering it for years and years. I'm actually legitimately trying to sell a good insulation product. I'm not trying to kill people or steal their money. I want people to have temperature control inside of their domiciles. There may be other people that live
in the inferior species.
What? Don't you? Isn't the point of working on a product to improve the product?
Ah!
point is to lock people into some sort of horrible indentured situation where they can't get out and they're just in this rat race, giving you more and more money and never establishing any sort of property or claim on their own.
Exactly. J-Bo, we're here
to... the galaxy works.
Yes. We're here to control people. Your products are supposed to help us control people. We can't control people with this...
titanium crystal.
Stupid thing.
It's titanium crystal.
Yes.
Well, can we dope it with something? You could, but that defeats the whole purpose of all my research.
We should dope it,
With galanium oxide.
Galanium oxide.
Yes.
No!
Oxide.
That only exists in Vontu.
The Vontu, they like profits as much as we do.
Yes.
The Vontu, the weird brain exposed species.
Yes, the Vontu.
They're not getting their hands on my titanium crystals. I'm sorry.
Sleep.
Thank you! Why did you wait so long?
Because I wanted him to feel like he was, like, helping and he was a part of it.
Okay, I'll go put his memories back where he, like, helped us to this decision. And then we'll finally be able to have this meeting.
Yes, put the fake thoughts in his mind.
Captain Duffy, I have, terrible news.
What?
Well, I've intercepted some communications from the, preparations for the convention, and, I don't think you're gonna get as much R&R as you were hoping. We've intercepted slides from a presentation. Captain, you are
pretty standard.
No, Captain, you're gonna receive a sales pitch. You're gonna have to listen, negotiate, respond. These are all things that require energy.
Can't I just nod, and then nod again at intervals that suggest listening?
Captain, as a communications official, I'm gonna say no. What's so beautiful and unique about it is when two people are really connected and... Oh, you're doing the nodding thing!
Was it working?
It was for a while, Captain! Right, you can test it out. You can try, but I'm not confident.
All right, rookie. This is what they call, in ancient times, a plunger. Okay, they use this to gain a little bit of, you gotta put a little energy into it.
Okay.
And then you just, and then, it would like, get the stuff up. But we don't need this shit anymore.
Oh.
Yeah, because
wow.
Now, what is the most important thing to space excrement?
That you excremented out into space.
Exactly, which requires a, fill in the blank.
A diaper!
No, wrong. Rookie, you've got so much to learn.
Okay.
I don't know, this is gonna take way too long. No. Come here, take a
seat. I'm just not good at quizzes.
This is an on-the-job learning experience. I didn't hire an apprentice for nothing. Look. The most important thing to space excrement is, you hear that sound? Wait for it. Oh, it's not working, hold on. All right, wait for it. All right, here we go. Pressed the wrong button, I'm sorry. What are you doing to my sister? I'm sorry, Iliad. I was just trying to extrapolate the point that, look, I've never had to teach anyone this job before. I've done it all by my hands. I've never had to explain it using words! I'm not good with words, Iliad!
That's fine, just don't touch the buttons that cause my thing to go wah.
I'm sorry. Vacuum! Vacuums are important!
Iliad, I did that. It's not her fault.
Oh, God, no. Well, thank you for taking responsibility.
Yeah, so if you have someone to blame me.
I will. Thank
okay,
you.
I'm the dum-dum.
Great, I will
say I'm
to...
stupid!
Okay.
I'm a big old dummy. Make sure the whole crew knows I did that.
Tone it back. Okay, I will.
Thank
if
you.
That's what you'd like.
I would.
Iliad to the entire crew of the Odyssey. Jason is a dummy. There we go.
Thank you.
Gib, Jacob, can I just talk with you for a moment?
Yes, Jomu.
Have you ever put me to sleep? Have you ever used that on me?
No. Not at all.
Okay.
You're my friend, Jomu. Of course I couldn't do that.
Look at me when he said it again. Have you ever put me to sleep?
Oh, of course not. I never could do that to you, my good friend.
I love you.
And I love you too, Joe.
As a business associate.
Yes, as business associates.
You seem nervous.
Nervous me? No. An intellect like myself is never nervous.
Let me ask you again, Gib. Have you ever put me to sleep?
Yes, I have!
What did you do to me?
Trust anybody at this galactic infrastructure convention. Oh, Jim, you made a grave mistake. One that is irreversible. Awake.
Oh, my God.
Oh, nothing. You were talking about how I am the one in control now, how I have all the power, and I'm the one who's going to lead the attack on the Odyssey when they arrive. And you are going to be a good little lackey.
Damn it. Don't do this to me. You know I want
to. That's
what
we were talking about. And then you just started freaking out on me.
Gib, I want more profits, all right? Can we at least, I want more. Let's cut J-Bo out.
Captain, do you really think it's a good idea for me and Emlu to accompany you together?
Yes. Got to put this to bed. Just look at the demonstrations. We'll do our talk.
Can we do the nodding thing where we just sort of nod like the other?
Okay. There's lots of goodies to be found. There's a couple mixers. We'll have some drinks. We'll just enjoy ourselves.
Somebody say drinks.
Captain, do you really think it's a good idea to have me and Berman go down with you?
Look, get a badge. Look at the schedule. We'll go to some mixers. I think that when you see each other outside of the ship in a less stressful situation, you're going to find common ground.
I believe you're wrong. I have no interest in spending one more moment with that man. If you send me down there, I cannot promise you I will not hurt him.
Oh, you can, because if I order you to go down there and not hurt him, then you can do both of those things.
Oh, you order me. That's so human of you.
Captain, I prepared the shuttle as requested for the away mission.
Yeah. Why don't you go keep the seat warm? Let's go, because you're going, and you're going non-violently.
Certainly, Captain.
Well! Thank you for taking me down, Captain. I'm very excited about the opportunity to be part of this away team. And Blue?
It's gonna be a lot of fun.
Captain, this is Norman. Captain, over.
Yes?
Can you hear me?
Yes.
I got one of my funny feelings about this mission.
Okay.
You know how I get those feelings.
You do.
Right. Right. That's it.
What?
What did you do, Berman?
I didn't do anything.
Oh, sure, yes.
Someone's locked in on us, and they're bringing us in on their steam.
How is that possible?
I'm not in charge of the steam anymore.
Hey, what happened? I was hiding at the cargo room. Oh. Well, you guys weren't supposed to know that until we landed. What's happening?
They're bringing us in. I'm not in control.
Why would they be bringing us into the conference, Captain?
I don't know.
Maybe it's my people. Maybe they're happy to see me.
Communication to the starship.
Accepted.
Hello. My name is Gib Gib. I am the one in charge of this galactic infrastructure convention conference.
We're very excited to be here to participate in the talks. I didn't think that taking over the ship like this was necessary.
Oh yes, there are some things, some protocols we have to abide by. You know, things that we have to do. Trust me when I say that everything will be just fine.
And trust me when I say I would like control back. And do that
trust
immediately.
Trust me when I say you don't need it. I've got it. Everything's good.
Okay, trust me when I say I prefer to drive myself.
Well, trust me when I say that if you don't let us take control of this ship, it will be the end of your days.
And trust me that I'm
okay with the trust me.
End communication. I don't trust them.
All right, Wookiee.
Elder Goofy. What the hell are you doing here? I'm plumbing.
Oh, I was looking for anybody to talk to. I just...
Hey, you can talk to us. No one listens to us anyway.
Yes, that's true. As Chief Communications Officer, you can say the same about me. You know?
Oh.
The only communication we know is toilets.
I can understand toilets.
All right. Well, this, like I was saying, Rookie, in the old times, my grandpa had one. It's called a pneumatic Voltron
pipe. I'm sorry, I'm a really empathetic person,
yeah,
and my heart's just with her right now.
Hey, I'm a really empathetic person, too. I could sense that you were empathizing with me.
Yeah,
I'm gonna have my toilet.
What's going on with your
yellow? People just nod and ignore me, like I'll be in the middle of a sentence and they'll start talking about, like, toilets and plumbing. Or Captain. Captain will just nod, even though I warned her that things are gonna happen. You ever feel that way?
Yeah, you know what, I'm more than a plumber, I really am.
Yeah, I heard over the comms the other day that you were also a big old dum-dum.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, and that's something. Not everybody can be a big old dum-dum.
Can I tell you something personal?
Absolutely.
The reason I get...
you okay?
What?
Thank you. I think you unlocked something.
Peppy!
What?
Are you shooting up my bathroom?
No!
I shot it up!
Jason, you dum-dum!
Yeah!
It was all him.
Wait, no, years ago I installed a secret communications device back here, right?
Oh!
I wanted a secure place where nobody could touch it, and I think you activated it.
Oh.
You installed it in my toilet?
Yeah, I needed a place that...
Wait! Wait!
Oh, that's not good.
You just severed connections to the away mission. We don't know what's going on.
It was an escape. It was meant to be an escape hatch. Like, if we ever needed to just cut ties with somebody, we could just push a button, and I didn't think it would happen now.
You know, if I get a dollar for every time someone installs an escape hatch in the toilets, I swear to God.
Esme, can you believe what those two idiots were trying to do with my titanium crystal? They want to get a Vontu involved? Those stupid brain on the outside of their head idiot species, they're just going to ruin this perfect product that I've been working on for years.
Perhaps not saying things about the Vontu that we need to get resources from would be good. Just think of it this way. You have a brilliant idea.
Yes, thank you.
Yes. And you want to bring it forth to the Academy and write a glorious paper about how wonderful it is.
That would be amazing.
But then what?
And then everyone's temperature would be controlled, and it would be a beautiful...
Yes, but then when you apply for millennia year, and you attempt to get a permanent position, you have one thing. and only one. But if you come up with something that's adequately covered, and everyone uses it, and then it breaks down, and you find a miraculous fix that makes it slightly more adequately good, then you write about paper, and so on. And then everyone goes to you, us, whenever they need their temperature controlled, and...
This sounds like a completely broken system that no scientific progress could possibly occur in any organized government!
Isn't it wonderful?
No! What foolish sort of government? Anyway, listen, the Odyssey has landed. They are here. I can't have any weird species messing with my perfectly devised solution to all these problems. I need your help with this. There can be no Vontu interruption.
No Vontu interruption.
No Vontu.
Well, then we have nothing left to say to one another.
Okay,
Captain, we have lost communication with the ship. I'm getting bad feelings about this galactic infrastructure convention.
Oh, yes, all of us are. Thanks.
Norman said she was feeling something, right? She had one of her feelings. The last time she had one of those feelings, I almost got iced.
I wanted this to be fun, and that was my mistake.
This could still be fun.
No.
I mean, we don't know that they're actually hostile.
Well, we're in a holding pen that we can't get out of after our away ship was taken over, so I'm telling you, I don't even think you need to be psychic to know that we're in trouble.
Hello, members of the Starship.
Hello?
Good to see this real well.
Captain Duffy.
I am Gib Gib. We're gonna shake hands.
I do. How's it going? Joking.
Thank you, Captain Duffy. This is my crew. Can you please explain to me why we're being held against our will?
Oh, you're just outsiders coming to a convention. We wanted to make sure that, you know, we had all relevant information about you. Can't have unknowns lurking around the convention.
Filled out all the registration. I assume there would be badges.
Paperwork is paperwork. It doesn't matter.
These guys are anti-paperwork. I'm getting a really bad feeling about them.
So we just need to hold you here for a little while longer. Make some inspections on your ship.
This is highly unusual.
Understand your technology.
You want to understand that thing? It's about to fall apart. That's all you need to know.
The contravention of every known way that our ship is supposed to be treated under every single treaty we have. This is a open convention.
Oh, you act like I care. Like, I'm not just going to do what I want. See, we've been watching you, Starship. Myself, Jomu, my other comrades and associates, and frankly, we're sick of it. The Starship roams the galaxy, going from planet to planet, fixing crises, installing infrastructure, trying to be the big heroes of the universe. Well, as an intellectual, I say you're foolish to think you could do that.
You're a fool. And I think it would be wise if you let us go now.
There's that Bantu chop.
Oh, there it is.
Didn't know you had someone from Vontu on your ship.
Oh, yes. Well, surprise.
We're not scared. We're not frightened by your kind. In fact, we find you quite ridiculous.
Ridiculous, huh?
She's got a gun.
Sleep!
You'd be wise to drop that.
Would I now?
We have a proposition, Bantuin! We have a proposition. We just want to talk.
The time for talk has ended.
How much are you paid
as a member of the Galactic Coalition?
I get paid by respect.
Respect?
By respect.
Oh.
Tell me!
Little part of me died.
What cards can you buy with respect? What power can you have with respect?
Where's the fun in respect?
Let me ask you this. Do your crew members treat you with respect?
Do they get your name correct?
Or are you just a stupid Vontuian?
Are you just an ugly
outside of your head brain, Bontuian.
You take that back.
I'm not using my own
you
words.
Take that back.
I'm using the words that we intercepted from your ship's log.
Very interesting, I think, from this one. Talking about the smell and how much he hated being near you and that you were loud.
Shut up!
Oh. Wow. That's not good. You have just started a war.
You know, Walther, like, I know we should be in crisis mode, but I can't stop feeling just, like, really good about us chatting, you know? I just kind of want to, like...
Can you do this somewhere else?
Jason, come talk to your mother. Now, why are you letting them broadcast you're a dum-dum? Why? You're better than that.
I took I take bullets for my bosses.
What a bunch of assholes. Hilliard, I'm having one of my bad feelings again, and it's not indigestion.
Yes, so am I. We are not in contact with the away mission.
Oh, shit.
And that keeps happening. There's gotta be something we can do to maybe break our way in. Is there any way we can...
Jason.
Yes?
When I told you 5 years ago to make that escape pod, did you do it?
Yeah, I listened to everything you say.
That's my boy. That's our way.
Is everyone installing things in the ship without asking me first? I am the computer.
Oh. Yes, we are. Maybe you should check your records every once in a while, Iliad. No shame, but...
So you have an escape pod?
Yeah, and it has a sound system.
Ooh, ooh. Fantastic. You yourself?
We're gonna woman it ourselves, yep. Hey, hon, you wanna come along?
Absolutely, yeah. I wanna get in more of this nitty gritty, you know?
Just... Iliad, you hold on to ship.
I will.
Okay, no pressure, we'll be back.
Come on. Nothing will go wrong, I assume.
Hey, Iliad, look, I know how important, like, you know, interaction is. I can't believe you're here alone. You're gonna go crazy, Iliad.
You're the only person who talks to me like I'm a person. I know that I'm just an AI, but I wanted to say thank you very much for that.
Aw, Iliad, you're so welcome. I'm always here to listen to you.
Why would you help
to me more? Iliad, I'm gonna miss you, Iliad, like a lot, okay?
What is this, a love story?
Well, let's just try to believe you're so smart. You know, like, you're smart. Like, I know you're built to be that way. You don't give you enough credit for that.
Thank you.
You're welcome. All right, I think I gotta run. Iliad, you're also, like, really beautiful,
no.
Okay? Okay, you know what?
Iliad, I'm really sorry you're so mean to you. You're just like, I should have told you about this escape pod. That was a mistake on my part. If you want to tell the ship I'm a dummy, you go ahead, because I'm a big dummy.
I will say it kindly now, you big dummy.
No.
Fuck you, Iliad.
Rookie?
Who am I going to explain the poop blast to? Who's going to learn plumbing history? Iliad.
Go, you're the only person left on ship.
Hi.
Everyone leaves the plumber. They always forget the plumber. No one thinks the plumber's important. That's it. That's all I had to say.
I think you're important.
Great, a robot thinks I'm important.
Well, what you said just struck me, actually. No one thinks the plumber is important. This is an infrastructure conference. It's plumbing, air conditioning. No one really cares about those things.
Yeah. You're telling me. They treat you like you're the poop on the bottom of their boots. And you know what I gotta say to that? It's shit.
Perhaps that's how they are feeling as well. Perhaps they feel like shit.
Yeah, so?
I'm thinking our crew is in a malicious situation.
A malicious situation?
Yes.
I haven't seen anything malicious in the pipes. I mean,
I'm going to pull up a view of the planet.
Can I be perfectly honest? I don't know what malicious means.
Oh, what with malice, bad intent. Mal comes from the Latin for bad.
Bad? You think the crew's in bad ways?
I think the crew is in bad ways. This is an overhead view of the conference area. Can you see?
Oh, I've been to this conference many times.
It's a bunch of different facilities. You know, there's the big party tent over there, and there's parking for all the ships over there.
But wait a minute, what's that on the blueprint? That's not supposed to be there. There's a whole wave going through the pipes. What is that?
I can't isolate it. These are outdated. I don't have anything recent.
Ilya, this is my chance. This is my chance to be a hero. I can rise above the ranks of plumber. I will be written into history books. People will call my name, and they will
have me. Sorry? Sorry, I ruined it?
That's exactly why I need to do this, Ilya. I'm going in there for the crew.
Jason, Han. All right. We're about to land. Han, you're back there?
Yeah.
Okay, just... so happy to be, you know. Yeah. It's such a small pod you built, honey. I wish we had a little more room, but here we are.
Mom, Han, we haven't had a chance to test out the sound system. I put in a karaoke machine. Is it okay?
Sure, honey. Give it a whirl.
I'm going to ask the Galactic Council for a karaoke song. Galactic Council? Can someone yell out a karaoke song over the space transmitter?
Wrecking Ball.
Wrecking Ball. I don't know that song, but Wrecking Ball.
Wrecking Ball. Wrecking Ball.
Wrecking Ball. We're wrecking some balls and the thing.
You wonderful. I've never told you enough how beautiful
there,
your voice
no,
is.
No, this is the actual song.
Oh, I used to love this hit. It's a real oldie of my great-great-great-great-grandmother's favorite collection. But you sang it better.
Go ahead and sing this one, though.
I know there's not enough room for me to do my dance in here, so I can't sing it.
Elder Norman,
yeah, I don't think you get enough credit for being so smart and so wise and brave.
I think you can do anything you've ever wanted, and I haven't told you that enough. I'm sorry.
Are you doing to me what you did to Ilya?
I don't need your interference. I just want to show you what a wonderful project I've come up with. And I heard that you have been buying it here. You must have ice in your veins, which can be perfectly warmed by good insulation and temperature control. Was it what? No?
J-Bo is the best at coming up with things like this that control temperature.
Yes.
We have a lot of faith in the work that he does. I mean that with sincerity. We have no plans on changing his design whatsoever.
Wow. That's great.
Sleep.
I don't feel well. Is it time for my talk?
No, but instead I have something else for the two of you to do. That machine there, we need you to rig it with explosives. We're going to put it on the Starship Odyssey and send a message to the people of Earth. In the entire
I am a member of the Galactic Infrastructure Convention.
Vermin! What have you done to them?
I am a member of the Galactic Infrastructure
Duffy.
Convention.
Listen to me, Von Toon. I have taken control of your crew members. I have made them see the error of their ways. And now they, along with everyone else in the Coalition, is going to learn. You shouldn't interfere with the rest of the galaxy. The universe is not yours to interfere with. And now you have to sit and watch. How does it feel? How does it feel? Look at the rest of that machine.
I won't. I won't.
Look at how I have your crew members control.
Stop it!
Infrastructure Convention.
Captain, can you hear me?
I am a member of the Galactic
Galactic Infrastructure Convention.
Wait, no, I thought I saved the day! I changed.
Damn it! Is anyone gonna buy some titanium crystals?
Oh, this was delightful! You deserve that! Oh, that was so much fun! Yes, so what do you say? Do you like the presentation? We're going to sell this, right? Great work, you three. Oh, God, that was gorgeous.
All hail, Jean-Luc.
All hail.
Oh, that was so delightful. So, your planet, you can talk them into the gallium oxide, right?
You sick monster. You're sick, you know that? I won't do any of this. You should kill me now, because I won't do this.
Oh, my God.
So the Vatu didn't want the gallium oxide to be infused with the titanium
crystals? No, he's one of the good guys.
Why, in my memory, is there just always all this...
Because I keep adding it to you, okay? I keep adding his memories to you.
And why would you do that?
You three, can you please come here? Can you stand here? We're gonna wake him back up. He's gonna talk about the gallium oxide. We wanna all just be part of this galactic infrastructure coalition. It's just a coalition of infrastructure people. Everyone loves infrastructure. It gets votes. People like it.
Jason, get our Wrecking Ball song on. We're going in.
Computer, Wrecking Ball song on. Action sequence mirrored to Wrecking Ball.
Pneumonic pipe, because they can make it up words, because they can figure out what to call it. No,
Iliad is
right. Well, years ago, I installed a communicator back here, and if you had messed with it,
woo, we would have been cut off, and who knows what would have happened.
Yeah, a lot of bad things would have happened. Take it from me. I had to invoke the protocol. We need to look at the planet surface.
Wait a minute, let me see your circuit boards. Holy shit, your protocol's been activated. Did you know that?
Amanda, you have a lot more work to do on the ship with communication.
You're right. And come down. I need to talk to Captain more. You know, I need to tell Captain how I feel when she ignores me.
I'm calling everyone back. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to ignore you.
Ilya, to the away team, Captain.
Yes, Ilya.
We need to pull back the away mission. I can't tell you now, and I can't tell you the whole story, but trust me, shit's gonna go down. You need to get back on ship.
And Captain, I think we should hang out. I think we should do fun things together, like maybe have like a karaoke night or something. Who knows?
Hey, I'm having a funny feeling about this mission. Should I radio them in? Or...
I did that already.
Oh, all right.
Norman, thank you for your intuition.
You're welcome. That's what I'm here for. Bye-bye. I need a private toilet. This one's
cool. Blue, Berman. It was one hell of a weekend, huh?
Oh, your rendition of Wrecking Ball was outstanding. I didn't know you had a voice like that, Emblu.
Well, I have to keep a certain, look on the ship, but I really finally felt free this weekend.
You sang like an angel.
I just want to apologize for how I've acted towards you.
I want to apologize how I acted towards you when I was a kid. Avantu kicked me in the groin. I've held against your people forever, but you are not that, Avantu. You are a good man.
You as well, Berman.
Wrecking Ball!
Excuse me, Captain. I'm sorry you had to see that.
Well, let's set a course for home. I hope it's your home, too.
It won't be, though. I understand.
Captain, maybe we should set a course for Bantu.
I think there might be just enough time.
Theater. That is it for tonight's show. Starship Odyssey runs through August 4th. Come back and see us again.